I think it's important for us when we're out enjoying recreating in the woods to be very mindful of what we're doing and the impact that we're having. That also applies really strongly to fires, right? You have a campfire, you've enjoyed some wonderful s'mores out in the woods. You need to make sure that that fire is out. Most important thing is that if you are still seeing flames or smoke or embers, if there's a breeze at all when you go to bed, you know, there's still potential for those embers to shoot out of your campfire, that's a danger. If you still see smoke, you can add water. You can also, you know, get that fire stick that you enjoyed poking the fire with, mix everything up, right? The more air that you can add to those embers, the more likely they are to go out, right? Especially at night, as the air cools down, the moisture in the air will increase. Even if you don't have water readily available, mixing it up more will help that cool down. If you have any big logs that are still burning, you know, kind of flipping them over and taking them out of that ash and char pile, you know, removing anything that's going to continue to burn for a long time. All of the motorized vehicles that we take out into the woods, that has heat associated with them. And so things like chainsaws and four-wheelers, dirt bikes have been known to cause fires under the right conditions also. So when, you know, you're thinking about tall, dry grass or those really light, flashy fuels that you would start your campfire with, that's where you need to be extra careful with that kind of equipment. On a dirt road, there's nothing to burn. You're probably okay. Cigarette butts are a really common way that fires start. When it comes to anything like cigarettes that we smoke outside, I would say it's really just leaving that ember that's gonna go out, right? If you're making sure that your cigarette is out and you are taking it with you, that's the best thing you can do. The leave no trace policy, you don't wanna leave that cigarette out burning in the woods, nor do you wanna just leave that butt out there just not burning in the woods. I think it's important that we all just remember that wildfires are an essential part to these landscapes. Not to say that all wildfires are good, and we certainly have experienced lots of catastrophic and what many would call bad fires, but it's important to understand how we got here and what we can do to prevent those next fires, which includes, you know, safety out in the woods when you're enjoying and recreating outside, but also the ability of land managers to be able to use fire in the future so that we can treat more of our landscape to prevent that next fire.